Hidalgo Noticias MX presenta.
Vamos a contestar preguntas, pero primero quedamos que íbamos a dar información sobre un video de un potentado estadounidense que hace una reflexión sobre el daño que causa la desigualdad, el que no haya conciencia de lo que se provoca cuando se acumula mucho capital en pocas manos, cuando pocos tienen mucho y muchos tienen poco. Eso al final provoca ingobernabilidad, confrontación, violencia. Y eso es lo que él expone. Y lo importante es que lo hace un hombre con mucho dinero. Sin duda es un empresario con dimensión social, con dimensión cívica.
You probably don't know me, but I am one of those 0.01 percenters that you hear about, read about, and I am by any reasonable definition a plutocrat. And tonight, what I would like to do is speak directly to other plutocrats, to my people, because it feels like it's time for us all to have a chat. Like most plutocrats, I too am a proud and unapologetic capitalist. I have founded, co-founded, or funded over 30 companies across a range of industries. I was the first non-family investor in Amazon.com. I co-founded a company called Aquantiv that we sold to Microsoft for $6.4 billion. My friends and I, we own a bank. I tell you this, unbelievable, right? I tell you this to show that my life is like most plutocrats. But let's be honest, I am not the smartest person you've ever met. I am certainly not the hardest working. I was a mediocre student. I'm not technical at all. I can't write a word of code. Truly, my success is the consequence of spectacular luck, of birth, of circumstance, and of timing. But I am actually pretty good at a couple of things. One, I have an unusually high tolerance for risk. And the other is, I have a good sense, a good intuition about what will happen in the future. And I think that that intuition about the future is the essence of good entrepreneurship. So what do I see in our future today, you ask? I see pitchforks, as in angry mobs with pitchforks. Because people like us plutocrats, because while people like us plutocrats are living beyond the dreams of avarice, the other 99% of our fellow citizens are falling farther and farther behind. If the trend continues, the top 1% will share over 30% of national wealth in another 30 years, while the bottom 50% of Americans will share just 6%. You see, the problem isn't that we have some inequality. Some inequality is necessary for a high-functioning capitalist democracy. The problem is that inequality is at historic highs today, and it's getting worse every day. And if wealth, power, and income continue to concentrate at the very tippy top, our society will change from a capitalist democracy to a neo-feudalist rentier society like 18th century France. That was, France before the revolution and the mobs with the pitchforks. So I have a message for my fellow plutocrats and zillionaires, and for anyone who lives in a gated bubble world. Wake up. Wake up. It cannot last. Because if we do not do something to fix the glaring economic inequities in our society, the pitchforks will come for us. For no free and open society can long sustain this kind of rising economic inequality. It has never happened. There are no examples. You show me a highly unequal society, and I will show you a police state or an uprising. The pitchforks will come for us if we do not address this. It's not a matter of if, it's when. And it will be terrible when they come for everyone. What I'm arguing is that rising economic inequality is stupid and ultimately self-defeating. Rising inequality doesn't just increase our risks from pitchforks, but it's also terrible for business too.